Hello students, welcome to the class on current affairs, and in this class we will be dealing with double taxation avoidance agreement amended with Singapore. Now this topic relates to economy. This will help you in general studies mains examination paper 3, plus this is also important for economics and public administration optional students. Now this is about double taxation avoidance agreement. So first of all, we need to understand what is this double taxation avoidance agreement and why such agreements came into being. What was the need of such agreements? Double taxation means it relates to something in which the double taxes were imposed. Double taxation avoidance means we need to avoid taxing something for two times. For the double times, avoidance, and this is a kind of a agreement. So double taxation avoidance agreement has been amended with Singapore. First of all, we need to understand why such agreements came into being. For that we need to understand the history of Indian economy. We need to go back about 25 years ago. About 25 years ago, in year 91, India opened up its economy. हमने क्या क्या 91 में introduce किया? Liberalization कर दिया, globalization कर दिया, privatization कर दिया. Liberalization, privatization, globalization को हमने introduce किया. सबसे important इस topic के लिए कौन सा aspect है? Liberalization and globalization. हमने अपनी economy को liberalize कर दिया और globalize कर दिया. ग्लोबलाइज करने का क्या मकसद था? ग्लोबलाइज करने का यह मकसद था कि ज्यादा से ज्यादा एफडीआई हिंदुस्तान में आए. तो एफडीआई क्या है? एफडीआई मींस फॉरेन डायरेक्ट इन्वेस्टमेंट. लोग बाहर से पैसा लेके आए, हिंदुस्तान में लगाए. सो दैट वाज द बेसिक पर्पस एंड इंटेंट बिहाइंड दिस लिबरलाइजेशन, प्राइवेटाइजेशन एंड ग्लोबलाइजेशन. बिकॉज इंडिया वॉज लैकिंग इन कैपिटल, हिंदुस्तानियों के पास हिंदुस्तान में पैसा नहीं था सरकार के पास. 91 में फाइनेंशियल क्राइसिस हो गया था हिंदुस्तान में. वी डोंट हैव टेक्नोलॉजी, वी डोंट हैव अ विजन टू डेवलप इंडियन इकोनॉमी. सो बिकॉज ऑफ दैट इंडिया वाज लुकिंग फॉर द सपोर्ट फ्रॉम द फॉरेन कॉर्पोरेट प्लेयर्स. सो इंडिया वांटेड दैट एफडीआई शुड बी कमिंग टू इंडिया. सो 91 वाज अ फेज आफ्टर विच द एफडीआई बिगिन टू कम in India. Now lot of FDI came in India, but there was a worry of the investors. Now, what kind of a worry? Worry means that when they were doing investment in India, now on the earnings that they were doing in India, they were paying the income tax, they were paying the capital gains tax, they were paying some of the taxes, and such kind of taxes they were paying not only to Indian government, but they were also paying to the from the place from where they have come, like suppose from Singapore, from Mauritius, or from United States of America. So this created a kind of a worry for the foreign direct investment players. They were not ready to invest because jitna kamayenge usse aadha to taxes mein chala jayega. So in this case, in order to assuage the concerns, in order to placate the concerns, what was done? The double taxation avoidance agreements were signed with the countries that nobody who would be doing investment in India would be taxed doubly. Either they should pay taxes to their government or they should pay taxes to India. So such kind of agreements came into being, and they were signed with various countries like Singapore, like Cyprus, like Mauritius and various other countries. But these three countries, they became very very notorious ones. Now why these countries, the agreements turned out to be notorious? They turned out to be notorious because in the case of Singapore, in the case of Cyprus and in the case of Mauritius, these countries, they have a very less domestic tax. Now what the companies begin to do? Now suppose I am an Indian player, and in order to avoid paying more taxes to the Indian government, what I was doing? I was opening my office in Singapore or in Cyprus or in Mauritius. And by opening my office in Singapore, Mauritius or Cyprus, I was showing to India as if I am a foreign player. Now, if I am a foreign player, under the provision of the Double Taxation Avoidance Agreement, I should be paying taxes either to the Indian government or to the Mauritius or Cyprus or Singapore government. And I ended up paying less taxes than Mauritius. So basically what was happening, in technical economic terms, this entire thing is known as round tripping. Round tripping. So basically I was resorting to this round tripping. And this is all domestic investment in order to avoid paying taxes, were resorting to this use of double taxation avoidance agreement. What was the purpose of DTAA? Purpose was to get FDI. But what purpose it was serving? It was serving the purpose to evade taxes. So the corporate class was misusing this very provision. And this is the provision that has recently been amended in the case of Mauritius, in the case of Cyprus, in the case of, now recently in the case of Singapore. Now what is the amendment? The amendment is, if you are in Singapore and you have been there for at least 3 years and you have spent about 27 lakh rupees staying there in 3 years, only in that case you will be allowed to get the benefits of double taxation avoidance agreement. And if you have not spent about 27 lakh rupees there in Singapore for last 3 years, in that case you will not be able to derive benefit of double taxation avoidance agreement. Whatever capital gain you will be doing, despite being a company from Singapore, you will be liable to pay taxes to the Indian government. So this is the basic intent behind this double taxation avoidance agreement amendment with Singapore. Now what question you will be getting in your mains examination? The question will be like, critically analyze the need to amend the tax laws with countries like Singapore, Mauritius and Cyprus. Critically analyze the importance of double taxation avoidance agreement in India getting FDI. Critically analyze the relationship between tax evasion, tax avoidance and FDI with respect to the DTAA. So these are the different type of the question that could be asked for exam. So this was all for this class. Now if you want to read more on this, please visit brainyias.com. You can also read a brainy map on this very topic, and you can also read note on this very topic. You can also install our application. Name of the application is Brainy IAS. Now this application has been downloaded by about 32,000 plus students. This application contains the entire current affair classes for 2017 and 18 batch. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.